So in operant conditioning, just understand, you know, if you people are here and I want you people to, you know, have a good understanding of psychology. So what is going to happen is that every time I'm conducting the test and... Hello everyone. Today we'll be solving previous year question paper of psychology. Now I have taken this topic wise analysis. That means right now I'll be doing the topic of learning. So what will happen is that you know, by topic wise we'll understand that how many questions came from which topic, and we'll also know that how to attempt that question in that time frame, and you know how effective it would be. So today I'll be taking the chapter of learning, and in 2024 we have three questions from learning. So let's begin. Now the first question that came from learning was that differentiate between classical conditioning. Differentiate between classical and operant conditioning. Discuss their applications with suitable examples. Now see, I have always focused in class what that you need to always have the applications with present day context. That means you know, all those things that are written in the books will not fetch you that much of marks. So that's the reason why, you know, students always have this query of why psychology paper is not providing us that good score. The reason being that we always are so book ridden that we always put examples which are there in books, but they are demanding you something more dynamic than that. Now how are you going to attempt this question is that first the question is saying that you need to differentiate between classical and operant conditioning. So definitely if you have studied classical and operant conditioning, so you will be knowing that classical conditioning is dealing with what? At unconditioned stimulus, then you have conditioned response, then you have conditioned stimulus, and then you have unconditioned response, right? So now you are going to explain all this in classical conditioning, and when it comes to operant conditioning, what you are going to do is that you are going to talk about reinforcements. You are going to talk about punishments. Now, when you are talking about this stimulus, and when you are talking about response, you will explain this. When operant conditioning, you will be talking about reinforcements and punishments. Now reinforcements, what is happening is, again, there is positive reinforcement, there is negative reinforcement, then there is positive punishment, then there is negative punishment. What you have to do is, you have to explain this all. Now this, all this is given in book, and all those who are the student of psychology will know that what are the definitions and how it varies from you know, one conditioning to the other. Now why have I taken this question is because it is asking about the applications with suitable examples. Now you also know that classical conditioning was the thing which was done by Pavlov. Here operant conditioning we have B.F. Skinner. Right. Now when you have to put the examples, that means the applications with suitable examples. So application part, again, this is marks fetching, and example is a different part. Now how are you going to explain this? You can go with the example of dog that was given by Pavlov, and here you can go with the experiment of the rat and the handle, which was given by B.F. Skinner. Now, application is more important to be dealt with, because this is more something which is going to grab attention. That means, what are the applications of classical conditioning? So, now you see, in classical conditioning, what is happening is, if I go with the application, now, classical conditioning is basically used for what? Making or bringing changes in the behavior of the people by associating it with something. For example, how? Now, here if you see, if you are going to attach what? Happiness with Coca-Cola. So, what is going to happen is that the people are getting conditioned. Conditioned as in what? That if they are going to prefer Coca-Cola, they are going to be more happy. So, if you see, classical conditioning is being used in your advertisement. So one of the example of advertisement could be Coca-Cola. It could be anything, you know, this is the reason why most of the these brands are getting endorsed by the celebrities. Fine. Now, if I come to operant conditioning, what is the, you know, this part of or what application is going to be served in operant conditioning? So in operant conditioning, just understand, you know, if you people are here and I want you people to, you know, have a good understanding of psychology. So what is going to happen is that every time I'm conducting the test and you know, I'm rewarding you with something. So basically it could be for training purpose, and training could be for any, you know, for anyone, like it could be for animals, it could be for humans. Fine. Other than that, it could also be used for educational purposes. And then it could also be used for motivational aspect. Fine. Here I told you about advertisement. You can also add about therapeutic approach. That means if you want to treat a person, so you can use this classical conditioning. So this is how you had to attempt this question. That means you had to give the difference between classical and operant conditioning. You had to explain this stimulus and the response conditioned, then you have to explain about reinforcements and punishment, then you have to talk about B.F. Skinner, then you have to talk about Pavlov, and then you have to talk about the dogs example. You had to talk about the application part, which talks about advertisement and this brand celebrities and conditioning. Then you have to talk about training part, then you have to talk about animals, humans, how educational purposes can be served by using operant conditioning. Fine. Now the next part of the question, or the next question, is does punishment work in all situation? Discuss the pros and cons of punishment. Now this is what I told you in the last question. They talked about conditioning and here they are talking about punishment. So now what you have to do is that you have to explain punishment and you have to talk about whether the punishment works in all situation. That means whether punishment is working in all situation. In that way, what is happening is, then you have to talk about positive punishments and negative punishment. Right? Now, positive punishment is what? That you want to bring desired change in person's behavior. And negative punishment is what? That you want to what? You want to decrease the person's behavior. Right? So how is this going to happen? Now they are talking about that you have to talk about the pros and you have to talk about the cons of the punishment. Now understand, if you talk about the pros and cons of the punishment, what is happening is, pros mein you will inculcate the learning habit. That means what is happening is that if you want to, you know, make the child learn about discipline, so what is going to happen is you are punishing the child. So that is a pro part. That means you are going to make a child learn ethical things. You want to bring desired changes in the behavior of the person. Fine. Then you want to make them more of well behaved person. Right? When it comes to cons, what is cons part of punishment? Now, punishing a child is not always going to bring effective result. Why? Because sometimes certain children get into very aggressive behavior. So what happens is that cons may, you will find that they either start yelling, they either start or become very aggressive, they turn out to be a rebel, right? Other than that, what happens is that they might get into, medically very unfit position. How? For example, there was a study that was conducted in US in which it said that, more of punishments that were engrossed upon the children's, what happened was that it led to more of a negative result. And what was that? The children's, psychologically, they become very disturbed. So more of, cases of depression or mental disorder started happening. Fine. So there are certain pros of the punishment, there are certain cons of the punishment. Now, cons of the punishment, other than all whatever I have told you, you have, this is how you have to attempt. That means you have to tell about all the repercussions that are going to happen. You have to also tell about the pros of the things. Why? Because if the children are not punished for wrong habits, what is going to happen? That they will never know about their boundaries. So pros mate, is very important that you should know about your clear boundaries. Fine. Chale, next question. Next question says, how do principles of classical conditioning helps in formation of likes and preferences? Now, I told you in the first question that you are going to give the definition of classical conditioning. That means you are going to start with what Pavlov said and what was the experiment of Pavlov with dog. Right, so this is going to serve your definition for classical conditioning. Now they say that how are you going to form the or formation of our likes and preferences. Now understand the market, for example, I just gave you one example in the previous slide, and that example was with reference to Coca-Cola. So now the market is having Coca-Cola and the market is having Pepsi. Right. Now, Coca-Cola and Pepsi both are present. Now, the point is that why should the user prefer Coca-Cola or why should the user prefer Pepsi? So, in that way, advertising agencies are conditioning you. How? Because now they will associate what? That there is a person who had this Coca-Cola and he became very happy. So, what is happening is that Coca-Cola is associated with happiness, right? Similarly, there are many other brands, this is how they are doing it. For example, if not this, then what? For example, if you see all those, beauty brands, right? Now, beauty brands are associating what? That if you are going to use this product, what is going to happen is that you are going to be more likable in the society. So beauty brands make you what? Relate this feeling of being likable. So now whenever you are, when people you are using beauty products, what happens is that they have associated themselves already that if I'm going to use it, then I'm going to look like this, and what is going to happen is that the society is going to accept me more. So that way beauty brands have associated liking factor. Coca-Cola has associated happiness with this. Then there are certain products, for example, if I remember, there's this product Mountain Dew. So it always says "Dar ke aage jeet hai," right? So what they are associating is fearlessness, right? I remember there's this one beauty product of Fair and Lovely. So their advertising style is that more the women are using this product, they feel like more independent they are. So what is happening is, this is how these brands are associating what certain response which is conditioned, and what happens is that people start preferring this because they have associated this feeling with the product. Fine. So this is how you had to attempt this question. There are many more things which need to be studied, but everything cannot be covered over here. It's just a glimpse how you have to attempt. Thank you so much.